Yo, what's going on? It's J-Pat back again with another video, and today I just kind of wanted to do a little sit-down talk video. We have a civil war right now in the rap game, and I feel like I just need to kind of get my thoughts on it. So much stuff has happened, I think, since the last time I talked about the whole J. Cole versus, you know, Kendrick beef. That's kind of ended now. Now it's kind of more of a bigger deal. Drake's really involved now. Kanye has now put himself in the spotlight, saying some crazy stuff. There's a lot of different people now. Now we have Quavo and Chris Brown are now beefing for some reason that no one really expected. It's almost like if anyone has any, you know, disagreements with anyone, they're letting it be known right now. Like, right now is the safe place. Everyone let their anger out, you know. Let the anger out. But yeah, I just kind of wanted to give my thoughts on it, and we'll start with, you know, how this all started. You know, Kendrick links up with Future and Metro on their album and drops a bomb, and it wasn't, like, looking back now, it wasn't like a crazy, crazy diss. Like, I just feel like it was kind of blown out of proportion. I think it's just the fact that it's Kendrick, and no one expected it, and he's basically saying, you could take it two different ways. He says, fuck the big three, it's just Big Me. You could take that two different ways. You could take it as him being like, fuck Drake and fuck J. Cole, I'm better than them. Or you could take it as like, I'm just him and like, stop comparing me to other people. And he didn't really say like much else about Drake and J. Cole in that diss. I mean, I don't know. It's two different ways you could take it, but I'm pretty sure most people took it as him saying fuck Drake and fuck J. Cole because they just wanted that response out of them. That happened. Obviously, J. Cole comes back with a diss track back at Kendrick, which a couple days after that. He goes ahead and apologizes for that and basically says, like, he doesn't want any smoke. And he gets a lot of hate for that, which you can kind of understand. It's rap, you know. So J. Cole kind of silences this part of it. But then everyone was waiting for Drake to come out with his diss track. And he does. He comes out with Push Up. Everyone was waiting for Drake to drop the bomb, and everyone knew like he wasn't gonna shy away. He wasn't gonna pull the J. Cole route and release something and then, you know, apologize for it. And this is it. And the beat's pretty good. The beat is pretty good. I think DJ Academics was the first one to really leak the song, and it kind of went crazy. It went viral. First thing he says, "I can never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand." I think he's talking about Kendrick there. I'm not 100%. He's saying pussies can't get booked outside America for nothing. He's in Tokyo, basically saying like he's worldwide superstar. The whole point of the song, I mean, the whole chorus and like the name of the song, Push Ups, is he's basically saying like they can't do 50 push ups. Just kind of funny. Like, sounds like a little like elementary kid like picking on their friend. Like, you can't do 50 push ups. It's like, that's odd, but. Let's keep on going. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. And that was a common theme in this song, was like Drake just kept going at Kendrick's height. And I looked up his height. He's 5'7". So yeah, he's pretty short. And this is what I really still don't understand. He says, you ain't in no big three. I mean, I get what he's saying there, but what does he mean by SZA got you wiped down, Travis got you wiped down, Savage got you wiped down? Like your label boy, you in a scope right now. He actually acknowledges the fact that he's getting teamed up on. He says, what the fuck is this? A 20v1 N-word. And then this is hilarious to me. And like, randomly, he decides to just diss Metro. He says, Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums. N-word. And then he says, I'll be rocking every fucking chain I own next visit. Hey, I'll be with some bodyguards like Whitney. And I heard that Whitney is actually Kendrick's wife. Or ex-wife, so it's getting definitely personal with it here. Every song that made it on the chart, he got from Drizzy, basically saying like he made Kendrick like popping, you know. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. I don't care what Cole think, that dot shit was weak as fuck. I don't care what Cole think. It's so interesting because like, it's clearly J. Cole doesn't want to be in this beef. He doesn't want himself in this situation at all. And like, J. Cole or Drake is the complete opposite. And like, Drake and J. Cole are like boys right now. So it's like, it's very interesting that like, J. Cole's not like sticking up for Drake, really. He hasn't really come out with anything. Charlotte Champagne tripping. He is not fucking easing up. And then he actually mentions Kai Sinai. He says, you done rolled deep to this. It's not fucking deep enough. Begging Kai Sinai, boy, you not fucking beating us. Damn. So I guess he was begging Kai for a stream. I think Kai came out and said, like, he never begged anyone. But yeah, that was it. A little DJ Academics sample at the end, a little snippet there, but yay. But yo, like this was a good day. Definitely better than J. Cole's. And it sucks to say, being a J. Cole fan. It was definitely better than J. Cole's. Now this definitely puts pressure on Kendrick now for a response. And I don't know, I feel like Kendrick's the type to like wait it out and like really take his time with it. And then here we go. Rick Ross is deciding to invite himself to the party and releases a song called Champagne Moments. And that's supposed to be a white version of Drake. And this shit is completely ass, bro. This shit is complete and utterly ass. Basically just calls Drake a white boy the entire song. There's really no substance in this song. There's no... It's hard to take Rick Ross serious. I'm not going to lie. Like, I don't take him serious. He's not he's a good rapper, but... Why is Rick Ross inviting himself to the party, man? Like, you're not on these guys' levels. Just stay out of it. You're just fishing for fucking clicks. You're fishing for fans. The diss was terrible. Like, Drake's not going to respond to Rick Ross out of everyone. He's not. Like I said, he basically just calls him a white boy the entire song. Like, it's not it for me. Not too long ago, Drake leaks another diss towards Kanye with an AI Tupac and an AI Snoop Dogg. I don't even know how he did it because it sounds so good. AI is getting so insane that like you can literally bring guys back from the dead and make it sound like they're actually alive. The Tupac was crazy. The Snoop Dogg thing was crazy. I don't even know how Drake got the approval for that. I don't even know if Drake was the one to make that song, but I can't believe he... If he did make that song, how the hell do you get approval or the rights to like put Tupac in? He's been dead for a year, 20, 30 years, and a diss. Like, I don't know. That's a crazy way to use a dead guy, a legend. But it was a good one. I don't know if Drake's gonna fully release it. I don't even know if Drake is the one that made that song. It could have been just a fan or something. And you knew that Kanye was not going to stay out of this. You knew it. You just know Kanye just, like, sniffs out drama and has to sniff himself into the drama. And that's exactly what he did. Coming out and leaking, wasn't a full release, but he posted on his YouTube that he had a Like That remix, which I haven't really listened to the full thing. It seemed like it was good from the beginning, but... No one really wanted him in this beef. No one asked for it. Kendrick and Drake go over the you know, be at the big kids table. But when asked why he did this Like That remix, he basically said like everyone was very excited for the elimination of Drake. I don't know, the way he words thing is very like dramatic and like dark, and I think he's just in a bad place mentally. Like he was literally like Drake and Kanye were good like a year ago. Like they did a concert together. I watched it. Now all of a sudden he hates Drake again. You never know with this guy. He's a roller coaster. He's up and down. You know, I feel bad losing his mom and his wife and probably his kids. But come on, Kanye. Like you need to just find your own happiness first. Like you need to find something in life to make you happy. Love your music. Love your legacy as a rapper. But this is leave this to Drake and Kendrick to battle out. I don't know. That's just my opinion. But this is what he says about Drake's diss track.
That's why every bar that Drake said that means nothing anymore in a dropping game. They don't even drop and do shit. Your raps don't mean shit, nigga. It doesn't mean because the shit is artificial. Lucy and Drake, all the shit is artificial. Wow. You know what I'm saying? That's why God's had to come. It's like... Pack that boy up.
I don't know. He said some crazy shit. He has some conspiracies, but we'll see if Drake responds to Kanye. I don't think he will, but we'll have to wait and see about that. Out of nowhere, while this is all going on, we get a random fucking the shot at Quavo from Chris Brown, and I like I don't know. I don't know if I'm like not into like the rap game that much, but because I did not know like Chris Brown could rap this good. I didn't know like he had beef with anyone. But this caught me so off guard, and it's actually a fire fucking song. Absolutely destroys Quavo here. Great fucking picture too, by the way. Great use of that picture. And I literally did not know Chris Brown could rap. I thought he was an R&B guy, that hard dancer. Like, this really surprised me.
You can settle this like you got some class, so we can get into some gangster shit.
Hey, Chris, I don't want no issues, bro. I don't want no smoke. I don't want fights, and I don't want to do nothing, bro.
Who wants smoke with me? Who wants smoke with me? Who wants smoke with me? Who wants smoke with C? Who wants smoke with me? Who wants? Okay, let's get down to the facts. Pussy, I'm drifting red. Don't let this R&B shit fool you niggas get ripped to shreds. Quavo talking like he a thug, nigga, you a bitch with dread. Can't wait to see the day that you back up all of that shit you said. What's all that bullshit you talking? You ain't no huncho, nigga. You the weakest link out of your clique. Let's keep it a hundo, nigga. You fuck my ex-ho, that's cool. I don't give no fuck, little nigga. Cause I fucked your ex when you was still with a bitch. I'm up, little nigga. Ooh. They say revenge is sweet. Now think about that shit. Don't let that line go over your head. I might just sing about that shit. I had a feeling about that dick. There's something sweet about that shit. I got some tea about that bitch, but I ain't gonna speak about that shit. I ain't playing chess with a checker player. I'm a ticking bomb on a detonator. I shit on niggas, I'm a defecator. I put amigo on a ventilator. Stop talking about beating some bullshit that we roll up on.
Bro, like, you can't tell me that shit ain't good, dude. That shit is fire. And then Quavo just a couple days ago releases Over Hoes and Bitches, and he has a Takeoff as a feature on this. It's pretty good. I think Chris Brown definitely won that first round. But yeah, let's take a look. This is more of like a song than a diss, though. You know, it's more of a song.
Little bitch, come dance battle with my Drake. You been fucked your bag up when you punch Ree in the face. Tell my fashion week, you sparing who? Come punch me in my face. It ain't nothing but a fade. You know you lost the frame. Niggas ran in your house, tied up your aunt cause you ain't pay. This bullet got your name. Don't ever bring up take.
This bullet got your name. Don't ever bring up take.
You know, half of y'all niggas some hoes out here. I'm talking about like, bleed nigga bleed, want some money type shit. Bitch. I call your hoe for pussy. I hit your hoe for pussy. I did the paper, come in to save you, but you gon' owe me pussy. I'm on the edge, don't push me on. You wanna defend your pussy. Come here to come in and did no time, can't fake it, we know that you pussy. We know it. Pussy, you, pussy, you,
pussy, you, pussy. Pussy.
Nigga, time after time, I pull up and wipe me a little baby nose. Pussy, nigga. Dropping the dime and pillow talking to these bitches and hoes. Pussy, nigga. Good ain't gold. Pussy, nigga. You been exposed.
Little boy wanna dollar some coochie. You still fucked up. We step in the yard, you know how that ended. Won't smoke with me. OHB mean fighting over hoes and bitches.
OHB.
Who gassed you up to put that out? Yeah, that was shitty, nigga. I can take a model bitch and make a sweetie, nigga.
Bitch.
Crackhead Michael Jackson, bitch, you better beat it, nigga. I'm still fucked up about Takeoff. I want who did it, nigga. But that's some real street shit. Back to the industry.
Oh, I can't believe like how good Takeoff is, man. Like, and that's the thing, I think he made a mistake, is putting Takeoff in this. Like, keep Takeoff, leave Takeoff out. Like, it's between you. It's between you and Chris Brown, and you just got bodied on this first round. Takeoff made it a little interesting there, but like, you got bodied by Chris Brown there. So like, basically, it's just a war right now. There's you got Batman, Spider-Man's there, Iron Man's there, Hulk's there. It's the Avengers just all battling it out. Kanye just invited himself in. J. Cole just basically just brought himself a lawn chair and cooked some popcorn. Is watching from the side now. Is there gonna be anyone else jumping in this war right now? Like, this is literally a war right now. Like, is anyone else gonna be jumping in? When is Kendrick? Because I think when Kendrick replies, that could either end this or I think it's gonna end it. Like, I think once Kendrick responds, like, there's something else Drake. Is it worth Drake replying again? Like, it just, I think it's all waiting upon a Kendrick reply. Pretty much, it's gonna be like a stalemate until Kendrick replies. But yeah, that's kind of what's been going on. It's interesting, it's entertaining. It's been a while since we had something like this happen in the rap game. But hey, let me know what you guys think about all this shit. Are you guys on the Drake side? Are you guys on the Kendrick side? Hit that like button, subscribe. See y'all next time. Let's go. Peace. Throw a stack on the Bible. Never Snapchat or took Molly. She fall through plenty, her and all her guineas.